This walkthrough will cover 8 important topics step by step, with the help of slides and code examples. I have covered everything you need to learn to work with C# Jagged Array. And if you watch all these short videos, you won't need any other video or tutorial on these topics again. Hello there. Welcome. I'm from CodeBuns. There are two types of multidimensional arrays, rectangular and jagged. I have already covered C# rectangular array in another video. In this video, I'm going to discuss C# jagged array in detail. And hopefully, my next video will be on the C# 8 switch expressions. Without wasting more time, let's get started. Please subscribe to this channel and make sure to hit the bell icon to receive notifications of my latest videos. What is jagged array? C# jagged array is an array of two or more dimensions. Most developers call it an array of arrays. Think of a jagged array as a table with rows of unequal lengths. Jagged array has a fixed number of elements. These fixed elements are actually the rows, like 3 rows, 4 rows, 5 rows, etc. As you can see, 3 rows here. Each fixed element, I mean every single row, can hold a separate array of different dimensions and sizes. This row contains a single dimensional array of length 2, or you can say 2 columns. And this row contains an array with 4 elements, 4 columns. This one with 3 elements, 3 columns. Actually, I prefer column instead of element. It helps visualize the image properly. You can call it whatever you like, column or element. Pay attention, please. Let me try to explain it again. This is a very important point. When you create a jagged array, you declare the number of fixed rows in the array. Hope that part is clear to you. Once declared the fixed rows, then for each row, this empty bracket will hold an array of different lengths or different columns. One array per fixed row. That can be a single or multidimensional array, 1D or 2D array. Let's look at the jagged array syntax. This is how you declare a jagged array. Let me explain it to you. On the declaration side, you need to have a data type. That's the type of elements in the array, like integer, decimal, string, etc. Followed by a pair of square brackets, one after another, 2 square brackets. These brackets represent the number of dimensions in the array. And finally, a variable name. Here is the declaration example. That's the declaration part. Now the initialization part. Pay attention, please. On the right side of the initialization, new keyword is used to create an array. After the new keyword, you specify a data type with 2 pair of square brackets, one after another. In the first pair of brackets, only the size that defines the number of fixed rows is set. Remember the term fixed elements from the previous slide? I mean these rows. You write the number of rows here. The second pair of brackets is empty. These brackets define the number of columns inside the row, and every row has different number of columns. Here is the initialization example. You can combine both these statements together, meaning declaration and initialization at the same time on a single line. See the example here. Actually, jagged array is a little bit tricky topic. I will try my best to simplify the topic as much as possible. That's why I use images to make sure you visually see while I am explaining it. Next, the demo will help you a lot. Array declaration and initialization. I'm going to use the C# online editor for the demo. You can find the link in the description below. Let me code the jagged array, then explain it to you. This part is the declaration of a jagged array. all the elements in this array will be of integer type, because I have used int data type here. Now, in order to use this array, I need to initialize it. Let me show you how. I have initialized the array with the new keyword, followed by the integer data type and two pairs of square brackets one after another. Within the first square brackets, I have number 3, which means this jagged array consists of 3 fixed rows. You can combine both these statements in a single statement like this. This statement declares and initializes the array both at the same time on a single line. This number 3 indicates the number of fixed rows, and these are the row indexes 0, 1, and 2. Okay, fine. Now the most important point is this. Focus, please. This empty square bracket shows that the number of columns in each row is undefined. To support this video, I have written a complete step-by-step article on C# Jagged Array. I have used images and code examples just to make sure you understand the topic thoroughly. You can find the article link in the description. And one request, if you like the article, please share it.